Hi, I'm Scott, and I'm recording a quick video to explain a simple but effective system that I use to get my three young kids ready for school and out the door in the morning without too much yelling. And this is a really low quality video. I'm just recording our family iPad, which is what I use. And with the idea of perfect being the enemy of good enough, I'm just going to go for it and record this. So it's a pretty simple idea. What I do is we've set up a whole bunch of alarms on our iPad. So I go to clock, and then here in the clock app, there's the world clock. And what we want is alarm at the bottom. And what I've set up is a bunch of different alarms. Now, our morning routine on school days has the kids getting up anytime after 6:30, and they typically are up around 6:30, 6:40 and starting breakfast. And the way that this system works is that it plays songs at certain times, and the same song gets played at the same time every day. So the song acts as like an audio cue to help the kids figure out how the morning is going. It actually works better for me and for my wife than for the kids, but anyway, it still works actually fairly well. So the first one is breakfast midpoint at 6:55, and I'm just going to cycle through them here. The next one at 7:22 is a 5-minute song that we play to signify the end of breakfast. And the idea with this is that by the end of this song, they should be done eating breakfast. Now that the kids are older, they don't actually need this quite as much as they used to when they were really young, but it helps quite a bit. After that, we need to get out the door by about 8:15, 8:17. So there's another song that plays at 7:42, and right now this is one of the songs that my oldest son is learning in violin. So it's just sort of I'm taking advantage of playing yet another song to remind us all that, hey, we need to get things going. Where it really comes in handy, though, is that I have two songs at the end here, one at 8:02 and another one at 8:08. And you can cycle through these just by tapping on them. But you can also, if you go up to the top left and click edit, you can see them all there too. And again, the first three are just sort of reminders that we need to do a routine. The ones that really get us ready, dressed in our snow pants and everything, and out the door on time are the last two. So at 8:02, I have a song that says, get ready to stop playing. And that runs every weekday. And it's about a 5.5-minute song, I think. I guess I can tap on it here, although I don't think it shows me. It's a song called Counting 1 to 10. So I have this repeating at weekdays. It starts at 8:02. And in order to set it up, you actually go through and you can check on and check off all of these things to choose the days. I have a label just as a reminder. This shows up when it's playing so that if I forget or if my parents are helping to get the kids ready, they can actually read that, and it gives a cue for them to understand why it's playing music. In this case, it's playing a song called Counting 1 to 10, which is from a kid's CD that I think is by Key Wild and Mr. Clark, and I'll try to find a link for it that I can include in the description for you, just in case you're moon. I'm reading this Walk the Moon at the bottom. Just in case you're interested in Key Wild, it's a song that progresses one, and there's a verse about 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way to the number 10. And this is actually really helpful for me. The idea is not that as soon as the song starts playing, the kids have to stop what they do and get ready. The idea is that they need to be done playing when the song finishes. So what happens often is that I will have forgotten to brush my teeth, for example, in the morning, and then suddenly I'll hear this song, realize it's already on number 2 and think it's on number 2. I have probably about 4 minutes left. By the time it's getting to number 6 and 7, I know I only have 1 or 2 minutes left to do whatever I need to do so that I'm at the front door reminding the kids to get ready. That song actually gets cut off, then I'm going to cancel any changes here, but that song gets cut off by the next one at 8:08. And this is a 9-minute song, and I chose it, it's the William Tell Overture. I chose the 9-minute song and the William Tell Overture because I was inspired by my high school, which played the same song. And again, the idea is not so much that they need to do everything as soon as possible, but this is the reminder that we need to be out the door, closing the door ideally, when the song is done. And this ensures that we get outside on time to meet the school bus, to leave and meet any other friends that we're walking to school with, so that we actually get to school on time. And one of the cool things about this is that it ensures that the kids have enough time to get ready. I find that when we're going somewhere on the weekend, we actually end up yelling a lot more just because I think we forget that it takes time for everybody to get ready. And when the kids were really young, say 4 and under, we really did need 9 minutes to get everybody into their snow pants, especially in the winter, and get everything out the door. Now that they're quite a bit older, because my kids are now 5, 7, and 9, we can typically get ready faster, but I don't change anything. What it means is that we have 9 minutes set aside that we can use to get ready, and I'm confident that we can get out on time, as long as, you know, I guess nothing crazy unexpected happens. But even if it does, there's this cue playing in the background that can help me assess, as a parent, like whether we have enough time to deal with, I don't know, a hole in a pair of underpants or something like that, and we have to switch. And typically it's not so bad, especially now that the kids are old enough to get dressed on their own most of the time. In fact, now we often have time for sunscreen even, included in this time. I hope that this might be able to help you in some way. I would love for you to let me know in the comments if it does, and I wish you all the best in figuring out cool and easy ways to make life easier with the kids.